So who is the Holy Spirit? We gotta ask that, amen? He is the most amazing, wonderful, beautiful, kind, tender, sensitive, mighty person on the face of this earth. You say, John, on the face of this earth? Oh yeah, on the face of this earth, because you have to understand the Father is not here on earth. He's on His throne in heaven. Jesus is not here on the earth. I hear people say all the time, Jesus is in my heart. He's seated at the right hand of God. And the angel specifically said, this is Acts 1, 9 and 11, while the disciples watched, Jesus was taken up and a cloud received them out of their sight. The two angels said, men of Galilee, why do you stand gazing up into heaven? This same Jesus who was taken up from you into heaven will so come in like manner as you saw him go into heaven. In other words, he's gonna come in the clouds. Has he come in the clouds? No. There's some people that might think that, but you know, they're out in a ranch somewhere, you know, where we can't find them, but he hasn't come in the clouds yet. That means he's at the right hand of God in heaven. Because when Stephen was being stoned, Stephen looked and he saw the glory of God and Jesus standing at his right hand. I love that, how Jesus stood for his martyr to come home. I just love that. But you see, Jesus has been there ever since, you know, approximately 2,000 years ago. He's not here. I don't care how much you say he's in your heart. It's the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of Jesus Christ. Because the Holy Spirit is referred to as the Spirit of God the Father. Matthew 10, 20, Jesus made the statement, it is not you who speak, but the Spirit of your Father who speaks in you. Do you know who's speaking through me right now? The Spirit of my Father. You know, I used to, and I even tried it here before this taping, I used to try to, you know, preach my message. Oh, anybody that's ever preached before, that is a miserable, miserable thing because it's horrible. I can't preach. But then all of a sudden, what happens? The Spirit of my Father comes on me and I begin to speak the Word of God. Are you with me? Oh, I love Him. He's so amazing. He's never left me dry. He's never left me out to dry. He never leaves us nor forsakes us. He is the Spirit of God the Son. I said the Holy Spirit is the Spirit of God the Son. Philippians 1:19, for you know this will turn out for my deliverance through your prayer and the supply of the Spirit of Jesus Christ. How do the three work together? Well, 1 Corinthians chapter 12, verses 5 through 7 gives us a little window into it. We read, and there are differences of administrations, but the same Lord. That would be Jesus. There's differences of operations, but the same God which worketh all in all. That's God the Father. But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man to profit withal. So you can see what this shows us. It gives us an insight of how they work together. So we've got the Father operates, all right? That's verse 6, or in other words, He initiates. We have the Son who administrates, and then we have the Holy Spirit who manifests. Now, to help you get an understanding of this, let's say we want to build a house, okay? If we're going to build a house, what happens? You've got an architect, you got a foreman, and you got the people that actually build the house, the workers, right? The subs, right? Well, in that illustration, this is crude, but it works. God the Father's the architect, Jesus is the foreman, and the Holy Spirit's the workers that actually build the house. He's the manifester of creation. Are you with me? Because Jesus said in Matthew 12, 28, if I cast out demons by the Spirit of God. Now you hear that? If I cast out demons by the Spirit of God, but Luke's gospel records it this way. If I cast out demons with the finger of God. So, exact same situation. Matthew writes Spirit of God, Luke writes finger of God. So the Holy Spirit is the finger of God. Now listen, there's something you gotta understand. The Greeks always wrote according to form. You've got their statues and all that stuff, they're into all that stuff. The Hebrew writers would always write according to function. So that's why he's not actually fingers. This is like if I was trying to communicate to you how the Holy Spirit is. My hand does the work that my head desires my hand to do. You see, he's revealed as the finger of God, the hand of God, the arm of God. He delivered them with a strong hand and an outstretched arm. He delivered them by his Spirit. If you look at Psalm 8:3, when I consider your heavens, the work of your fingers. So the Holy Spirit is the one who actually put those stars in their orbit. Put the moon and the earth, because he says, the work of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have ordained. He's the one that manifested all creation. That's why he's hovering upon the waters, waiting for the architect to initiate and the sun to administrate by saying, light be, because Jesus is the word of God. So when light be was spoken, that was the Son. Are you with me? Administrating what the Father said to do, and the Holy Spirit made it happen. I love that. Man, that is so good. Are you with me?
Hey, what's up, everybody? My name is Nick Acosta, and I want to invite you guys to grow with me as I grow with God today. So let's grow in Christ. Who is the Holy Spirit? So we just watched this clip from John Bevere about who the Holy Spirit is. And it's just an amazing time of preaching and teaching, and he was just hitting so many scriptures about the Holy Spirit and what the New Testament and the Old Testament says about the Holy Spirit, who he is and what he does. And it's just something so important for us to get in today's day in the body of Christ. We must know who the Holy Spirit is. Why? So that we can just talk about him? No, so that we can allow him to live through us, and so that we can actually commune with him as well, because the Bible says the communion of the Holy Spirit, and the Bible says that the Holy Spirit works in us. Okay, so just before I get into this message here, just want to put a disclaimer out here that, you know, whenever I put a clip of a preacher or, you know, a minister, it doesn't mean that I agree 100% with everything they have ever said, they are saying, or they will ever say. It just means that whatever they said in this clip that I'm showing you was biblical, was good, and is worthy for us to listen to so that we can grow in our walk in Christ. Amen. So I hope you listen to this and I hope you get this. So the Holy Spirit, what John Bevere was saying is that, hey, Jesus is at the right hand of the Father in heaven, and so is the Father in heaven. So who are we communing with when we talk to God? Who is helping us pray? The Bible says that he helps us in our weaknesses and helps us to pray the will of God. The Bible says that he works in us, that it's his power in us, working in us. The Bible says that we are to walk according to the Holy Spirit. The Bible says that according to the Holy Spirit, we must walk and not according to the flesh, and that the flesh is contrary to the Spirit and the Spirit to the flesh, and they don't agree. They are at enmity. So who is this Holy Spirit? He is the Lord Jesus, the Father, God. The Bible says that the Spirit is the Spirit of the Father, as John Bevere just mentioned, and he is the Spirit of Jesus Christ, the Spirit of the Lord, right? The Bible says that now the Lord is the Spirit, and where the Spirit of the Lord is, there is liberty. We have quoted this scripture so much, and it's good and it's truth, but we forget that it says the Lord is the Spirit. That's why Jesus said, hey, the Comforter is coming, and he's not gonna be with you. The Holy Spirit will actually be in you. And that's why the same Jesus also said, hey, I will never leave you or forsake you. I will not leave you abandoned. I will be with you even to the end of the age. And right after that, he ascended. He went to heaven. It's like, did he break his promise and, you know, in like 2 minutes after he said it? No. He sent the Spirit. And God is the Father. God is the Son. God is the Spirit. That's why in the beginning, before anything was created, God was already there. He's self-existent and eternal. The Spirit was already there. The Word of God was already there. John 1 says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God. And it says the Word was God. And then it says the Word became flesh and manifested among his own creation. Who do we know that manifested? Jesus. So who else was John 1 in regards to the Word in the beginning, who else was he referring to other than Jesus? Of course, Jesus Christ, right? Born through the Virgin Mary. So all this video is saying is that, hey, the Holy Spirit that the Bible says is within believers is God himself. That's why it says that he will never leave us or forsake us. And it says that our bodies are now the temples of God and the temples of the Holy Spirit. Same person, same Lord. So I just want you to get this, because the Bible says that the Holy Spirit manifests and works, and that the Holy Spirit, just like John Bevere said in the video, is the one who makes the things that the Father wants to happen. He's the one that makes them manifest. He's the one that works the things into existence, into manifestations. That's why the Bible talks about the graces of the Holy Spirit, the gifts of the Holy Spirit, the manifestations of the Holy Spirit. That's why Jesus said, hey, if I'm casting out demons, it's by the finger of God or by the Spirit of God, right? And it shows that the kingdom is here. Anytime the Holy Spirit manifests, it's manifesting what the kingdom of God looks like. Straight power and holiness and righteousness and truth and grace, right? And conviction, right? Sometimes judgment, wrath, righteous anger, peace, joy, whatever it is. Healing, miracles, it's the Holy Spirit manifesting, and it's making wherever we are look like the kingdom of God. And that's exactly how Jesus walked, and that's exactly how he wants us to walk, by the power of the Holy Spirit. That's why he says, follow me. That's why he says, same works. That's why he says, hey, it's good that I go away to the Father, because I'm gonna send the Comforter, the Holy Spirit. It's just as if Jesus was here walking with us physically, like he did with his disciples. It's the Holy Spirit in us, leading us, right? It says follow Jesus, but the Bible also says be led by the Spirit. How are we led by the Spirit? Does that mean we're following the Spirit? Yes, because he's the same Jesus, same Lord, same God, same Father. It's all the same thing, and it's all us obeying God, submitting to God, being led by God, right? Allowing the Lord to order our steps, allowing the Lord to live in us and work through us. The Bible says we have been crucified with Christ, and it's no longer us who live, but God, right? Christ, right? The Lord who lives in us. How? By the Spirit. So if the Holy Spirit worked things, ever was working things into existence ever since the beginning, ever since Genesis, and he's God, and the Bible says God is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He's the one who was, is, and is to come. He doesn't lie, he doesn't change. There is no type of fakeness about God. He never changes. And the Bible says that the Holy Spirit that we have within is God himself. What do you think he wants to do in our lives? He wants to do the same type of powerful, awesome, holy, supernatural works through us, because it's the same Lord that was doing things through the apostles, through Stephen, through Jesus Christ. Jesus said, hey, it's the Spirit of my Father working the works through me. I cast out demons by the Spirit of God. So that's why he said, hey, you continue the ministry that I have. Continue the ministry of reconciliation, right? Telling people about peace with God through me. Telling people about the ministry of reconciliation. Jesus came so that man will be reconciled to God. Through faith in Christ, right? Through repentance, right? Through being born again, receiving the forgiveness of our sins, receiving the indwelling presence of the Holy Spirit, having our names written in the Lamb's Book of Life. It's powerful. That's the same ministry we have today. So today I just want to encourage you and remind you that you have the Holy Spirit within as a believer of Jesus Christ, and he is God, and he wants to do powerful, amazing things in you and through you, because he's the one, amen, remember, who manifests, amen, he manifests, he's the one who manifests, who works things. It's like John Bevere read all those scriptures that prove that the Holy Spirit works, he manifests, he acts on the things that God wants to happen and bring about. He wants to bring good fruit. That's why it says the fruit of the Spirit. We're supposed to produce good fruit now as Christians. Why? Because the Spirit is within and he is holy. That's why it says the gifts of the Spirit. Jesus said, you will lay hands on the sick and they will recover. Why? Are we magicians? Are we special? Are we gods? No, because the Holy Spirit is within us and he is God. And of course he's able to heal. So be encouraged today by remembering the Spirit is in you, and it means God is in you. So why act as if we can't live the life that Jesus has called us to live? The Spirit is willing. The Spirit is able. The Spirit is powerful. He's within you and I, and he is God. If this video blessed you, please subscribe to this channel. I'm gonna be coming out with videos way more frequently, consistently than I have ever before. There's a message that I wanna put out into the body of Christ, and I'm gonna just flood YouTube with these messages. So please subscribe to the channel, like the video, and comment on it so that more people can view it, okay? I love you guys, bless you guys, and I'll see you next time. Let's grow.